Come on with me to Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 7. The Bible says, with good will doing service as to who? As to the Lord and not to who? Can I read it again? With good will doing service as to the Lord and not to me. Render your service to the Lord and not to me. I got to go there one more time. Render your service unto the Lord and not to me. Do the will of God from your heart to please God and not please me. Can I break it down? Can I really break it down? Can I come on in tonight and tell more? Quit when they're doing it unto me. You can't quit if you're doing it unto the Lord. Talk to me, somebody. You quit when you're doing it unto me. But you can't quit when you're doing it unto the Lord. Can I make it that out? I hear people say sometimes there are too many hypocrites in church. And I always say they need to be in church too, amen. They said too many hypocrites in church. That's why I don't go to church. Well, mama used to say that. She said, you're not going to church to serve man. You better talk to me this morning. You're going to church to serve the Lord. I hear too many people say, you know, I don't go to church because there are too many bad pastors. Watch us now. Bad ministers, bad members, bad people, bad this, bad that. Well, you don't stop eating because you ate some bad food. You need food to live. You need Christ. Somebody to live. I don't care how bad the people are or how bad you think they are. You're not coming to church to please men. You're coming to church, help me, Holy Ghost, to please the Lord. You're not trying to satisfy men. He was asked, what was he doing? His answer was, I'm building a cathedral for the Lord. Everything I'm doing unto the Lord. Put your whole soul in your job. Give him a neighbor. Oh, neighbor. Put your whole soul in your job. Can I bring it down? If you used to be a choir member, you were working unto the Lord. If you used to be an usher, get on back on that usher board again. You were working unto the Lord. If you used to be a missionary, get on back on that missionary board. You were working unto the Lord. Whatever you used to do, Second Deuteronomy chapter 5 and verse 10. The Bible says, for we must what? Tell three neighbors, all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that he hath done. Whether, you better help me now, whether it be good or bad. That brings me to the last principle. Principle number 4. God is going to repay you for what you have done in this body, in this life. Can I back it up? Ephesians chapter 6 and verse number 8. The Bible says, knowing that whatsoever good thing any man doeth, the same shall he receive of the Lord, whether he be bond or free. I'm going to surprise you this morning. When you work, you're not working for Pastor Mark. Do you know why? I don't have no heaven, and I don't have no hell to give you. You're only working for the Lord. Only what you do for Christ will last in the end. Am I right about it? Don't let anybody or somebody or everybody make you quit, because they don't have no heaven or no hell to give you. You're not serving them. You're not working for them. You're working for Christ. I'm here to tell you this morning, you reap. I wish y'all knew what I'm talking about. You reap what you sow, what you do will come back to you. If you do good, Paul said, good, old slave, will come back to you. Are we going to receive a reward? Yes, you are. And it's not going to be from man. It's going to be from Christ. But now, before I close out, and before I end, I know what you were thinking. You was thinking about like I was thinking when I was in college, in school. What about this question, Paul? What about slavery? I want you to deal with that thing. What about slavery? Well, Paul knows something that I didn't know then, but I know it now. Paul knows that if Christianity is truly practiced, then slavery cannot last. He knows that in the seed of the gospel was the destruction of slavery. The wall of partition had to come down that divided men against men against women, and race against race. Can I back it up? Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 9. For Bible says, good God Almighty, and ye masters, got to deal with them now, do the same thing unto them. Forbearing, threatening, cut out all that threatening, knowing that your master, and I want you to note right there, that master doesn't have a little M in front of it. See, your master is with a little M. This has a capital M in front of it. There's only one master, only one true master with a capital M on it. When you look at the beginning, say, hey, ye master with a little M. I want to talk to you about a master with a capital M. Do the same claiming from the devil. Neither is there respect of persons who live here. Can I take it down? In the NIV says there's no favoritism with him. Can I break it down? In the New American Standard Bible says there's no partiality with him. Can I break it down? In the New Living Translation says there is no favorites with him. Here comes slavery coming down in the seed of the gospel. Paul, ministry. Can y'all hear me? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
when they come. There's only one freedom. I stir you this morning that you might share and preach the gospel with everybody, in men and women, boys and girls, will get saved by the gospel. Can I land right here? Oh, there's two verses I want to land on. John chapter 8, verse 36. John 8 and 36. The Bible says, if the Son, therefore, shall make you free, hallelujah, ye shall be free indeed. Y'all remember that? 1, 2, 3 together.
If the Son,
therefore, shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. Don't turn yes and say, there's a whole lot of folks in prison, but they're not behind bars. They're out loose here, but they're in prison for the wrong. They're tied up, knotted up, bounded up, all locked up, but outside the wall. Can I break it down? I'm getting deep in you. I'm getting deep on you. Preaching, teaching of the gospel. Brother Gray, as those grandchildren hear that gospel, they can never be enslaved. Oh, Frederick Douglass say, teach a man to read, he'll never be a slave. Amen. But I got something better than that. Give somebody the gospel, they always be free. I don't care where they are, they'll be free. Be shackled all down and say, I'm a free man. I want you as free as I am free. Answer from the body, present with the Lord. Y'all with me? If I count to three, let's read together. 1, 2, 3 together. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Give God a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Through the power of the gospel.